What is the significance of lighting a deepa, lighting the lamp? Why has it got so much of importance? Especially in our tradition, we give lots of importance to lighting a lamp. When the lamp is being lit, they say, don't show your back. All of you turn this side. Because why? Deepam is being lit over there. So lots of importance, any function. It can be a spiritual function, it can be a religious function, a festival, it can be a materialistic, it can be a function out there in an office. Everything we start with lighting the lamp, inauguration. We light the lamp, the chief guest is called. Lighting the lamp will be one item over there in the program. Light the lamp and then only start the program. So there also, when the person is lighting the lamp, focusing will be there, concentration will be there, all of us, our attention will be there. When the lamp is being lit, why? So that is the one which helps us to start or undertake whatever we want to do in our future. It's very, very important. Why is this lamp lighting so important? It's very important because that lamp that I light over there, outside, whether it is in the puja room or whether it is in our courtyard or near the door, is all about bringing light into our lives. It's as simple as that. We want to bring light into our lives. And the whole thing is symbolically it is represented over there when we light the lamp. Who amongst us do not want to bring light into our lives? All of us want to bring light into our lives. Why? Because without light, we can't transact at all. Outside we can't transact, within ourselves also we can't do anything. The body needs light outside to transact, to act. The mind and the intellect also, for them, those instruments to perform in us, they need a special inner light also. So the whole concept of lighting a lamp is to bring light into our lives. That is why it's so important. Now when we come to the lamp itself, there are four parts in the lamp. One is the vessel, which is going to contain the oil or the ghee. Vessel is there, oil or ghee is there, the wick is there, and the flame is there. Four parts are there. Very beautifully, what do they signify? All of them are actually one. Therefore, in our tradition again, what is the lamp made up of is very important. In Deepavali, they say, best lamp is mud lamp. Mud represents, we'll see what that mud represents in us, earthen lamp. So there are some materials with which only we make the lamp. So only those materials should be used. So the material which has gone into making the lamp is very important. Then what is it that fills up the vessel? The oil that we use or the ghee that we use. We can't use anything. There are certain ingredients only that should be used as the substance that is there inside it. Not oil, all oils are not used. Only certain oils are used. Then, what is the wick made up of is very important. Anything we can't take and make it into a wick. How many strands must be there in the wick? How should it be? Should it be all loose or should it be all stiff? There is a meaning, reason behind it all, meaning behind it all. And then there is a flame also. All of them put together, what is it that they are symbolizing for us is very, very important. We are all walking lamps. Each of us is a walking lamp. So we are all lamps. There is a lamp outside also, outside of us. That lamp represents each one of us. Before we come to us, we'll see what is its contribution. Does the lamp have anything to teach us? It has lots to teach us. First of all, it says, I don't give light to myself alone. I give light to everybody else. We are not like that. We are very selfish. I and mine. Beyond that, we don't think at all. But the lamp says no. Not only I give, yes, we have to give light to ourselves also. Our welfare also should be there. But our welfare should not be at the cost of somebody else's welfare. Our welfare should include everybody else's welfare also. Only then it is Shreyaskar. Otherwise it is harmful and destructive, both to ourselves and to the entire environment of things and beings. So the lamp there, first of all, it teaches us, not only I give light to myself, but I give light to everybody. Without asking, did we ask its permission? You have asked, therefore I am giving you light. No, it just stays over there and gives light. Use me, it says. See the karma yoga there? So therefore, if that is one of the points. Secondly, whatever vibrations come out, there is an energy field created around every lamp. It's very, very positive. And also, what oil we are using or ghee we are using, the energy field depends on that also. So that's why only certain oils are used and ghee is used. Because when they are all participating over there and when the flame is burning over there, it burns because of the fuel that it is using, the oil that it is taking in. So that oil has got its own characteristics. And therefore when the flame is burning bright, it emits certain vibrations which are very, very useful to the entire environment. There's an energy field around. So therefore it takes care of that also. It cleans up the entire environment. Not only it gives light, not only it gives warmth, but it cleans up the entire environment with positivity and good vibrations. And also the flame is always pointing upward. It's never pointing downward. Therefore it's telling us, always go up, never come down. Go forward, don't backstep in your life. Move ahead, and move higher and higher and higher. The flame always points upward, it never points downward at all. So by pointing upwards constantly, what is the lamp trying to teach? Silently it is teaching us. It's the guru there, the teacher teaching us. Always look up, move ahead, move high upward. Slowly, slowly let there be evolution, not a devolution. Again, it can be materialistic life or it can be spiritual life, it doesn't matter. But we should move ahead and we should move higher and higher and higher. It teaches us that. And also, if you observe, a flame looks to be complete. Oh, it looks like this. But that big flame that we are seeing it as one. But it is made up of numerous flamelets. Small, 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 small little flickerings. They've all collected together. They are almost stuck together. And then they give us a feeling of completeness over there. Actually, they're all small, small little flamelets. Flickerings they are all. Separate, separate, separate. But they've all collected together to give to us that beautiful looking flame over there. It teaches us something. Divide and do, divide, divide. Man is only, always we see differences, differentiation, I, she, he, it. Separate, separate, separate. We always disintegrate things. The flame is telling us over there, collect things. Become whole. Yes, there are many. But why don't you learn to see the togetherness that is there, the cohesiveness that is there. Collect everything in and around you and about you. Everything is one whole unit, is what it is teaching us all. So there is the individuals, there is the universe. It's teaching us over there. Individual flamelets are there. But see, so many flamelets we have collected together. And we have become one big flame. So it teaches us togetherness. It teaches us bonding. They're all bound to each other. Those small little flamelets. Bonding. It teaches us cohesiveness. We are all one family when we say, we should really mean it. We say with the mouth. But inside we are completely different. Not only in a family, extended at international level. All the 14 worlds are one. But each one is separate. We should learn to completely bring together everything, embrace everything together. We can't do it outside there. We have to accomplish it within ourselves. That is called realization. Total realization. That all things and all beings are me, myself. And me, myself is there in everything and in everything. The vision of a master, the vision of a prophet is being symbolized over there in the form of the flame over there. That is why so much of importance to it. So there, and so this is one aspect. Another aspect is, we next time when we light a deepam, when we carry the deepam from wherever we are carrying it to wherever we are carrying, we should become a little more sensitive and see what's happening within me. Thoughts become calm. We become a little more quiet. That restlessness in us will, just by merely holding the lamp it, or the deepam in our hand, touch therapy will be there. Mud lamp I am holding in my hand. That also is mud, I am also mud. Mud attraction is there. Somewhere, some little bit of quietude will come in, calmness will come in to our unknown it is. So there is a touch therapy there. When we see the lamp, there is visual therapy there. That is, many people, there are certain meditations wherein they are asked to focus on the flame there. Visual therapy is there. And whatever oil or ghee we have used for the lamp, somehow it spreads. We will know whether we have lit an oil lamp or we have lit a ghee lamp. And those who are even more sensitive can tell us what oil they have used also. Aroma therapy is there. Some of the therapies get taken care of. There is no taste therapy there, but still. See, many things get taken care of over there. All these things happen to us when we light a lamp over there. And when we are lighting the lamp, it tells her, you are lighting me, remember, I not only give light to myself, but I am giving light to everybody. Similarly, you also become one like that. Not only you give light to yourself and make your life a celebration, why don't you make everybody's life also a celebration? Whoever at least comes in contact with you, at least that much, is what it is indicating to us. Then there is another aspect also. I already did say we are all walking lamps. How can I connect myself with the lamp over there? There are different interpretations for that. One or two only I am now sharing with everybody over here. The body is the lamp. Our body is a lamp. Mitti. The body is made up of mud. The lamp also is made up of mud. Or if it's made up of any other metal also, basically metal belongs to Mother Earth. So in that sense, the body is for us a lamp, the vessel. In that vessel, we have to put oil. What is the oil? Oil is dravya, liquid it is. Thoughts are there in us. Liquid there, thought flow we say. Thoughts flow in us, in our mind. Mind is nothing but thought flow. So just as oil flows, just as water flows, thoughts flow in us. So in this vessel called the body, I have filled it up with my thoughts, good thoughts. We don't use anything that we want, we can't use as a fuel over there. So therefore good thoughts over there. So the oil there represents our thoughts, mind we can say. Mind is the oil. What is the wick? The intellect in us. Sturdy, strong, uncompromising, unyielding, full of faith. No matter what happens in our lives, still I do not stop, I move ahead. Even when we bring that cotton wick at home, we nicely, make it stiff, make it strong over there. And the number of strands also differs. Only one of the aspects I will take, I can't take in all. I will use that for the next one. But there is a meaning behind why the wick is made up of only that number of strands. Philosophically, there is a meaning behind it. So the intellect there represents the wick, or the wick represents the intellect. And what is the flame over there? The life that is there in us. Consciousness is there. Chaitanya, we say. Without that, If somebody is dead and gone, we say Deepa Aroitu. The flame has got extinguished. So the flame over there represents the divine principle or the life, or if you want to have the saguna aspect, we can say Bhagavan himself represents the flame. He is all light, we say. Lord is all light. Sat Chit Ananda, he is Chit, he is light. Light of all lights, he is. So therefore, this is one aspect. So very nicely, we can relate to the lamp over there. Body is the lamp, mind is the oil, intellect is the wick, and the flame there is Bhagavan himself, in a life itself in us. Automatically, no, many of the negativities will drop off from us if we start contemplating on these lines. Every moment, I am a lamp, I am a lamp. This is the vessel, this is the oil, this is the wick, and this is the flame. Overnight, it can transform us and change us for the better. So this is one aspect of it. How we relate ourselves to the lamp over there. There is another interpretation also. Many are there. I am just using one or two of them. That's it. And the other one is, the mind is the vessel. Earlier we said the body was the vessel. The mind is the vessel now. So if this is an outer lamp, outside lamp, there is an inside lamp also. Antar Jyotihi, Bahir Jyotihi. Outside there is light, inside there is light. Light of all light, everywhere there is light and light and light alone. So if we all represent an external Deepam, there is an internal Deepam also in us. And what is it? The mind is the vessel over there. Into that, I fill it up with the oil of devotion. The wick is the Shraddha, faith. And what is the flame? Knowledge that comes into us. The concept is so beautiful. I am repeating again. The vessel is the mind. The oil is devotion. Devotion is softer. Love. Love flows. Love flows from us to others. And love from others flows to us. Faith is hard. Tough it is. So therefore, in the mind called the vessel, we fill it up with devotion. We put the wick of Shraddha, faith. And then we bring in knowledge. That is why they say, light of knowledge. Bring the light of knowledge into your life. It's there. Actually, it's all veiled up and covered. So therefore, all that we have to do, achieve in our life is uncovering. But then we will not understand it. Therefore, we are all like lamps which are off. Off Deepam's sphere. Therefore, they say, bring the light in. Bring the light of knowledge into your life. Bring the light of knowledge into your life. How to do it? Get the lamp ready. Clean up the mind, clean up the lamp, and then pour the oil of devotion, put the wick called Shraddha there, bring the knowledge in. Then our lives also will be as brilliant, as luminous, as shining as the flame over there. Another version also is there. Body is again, I am repeating, the lamp, vessel, into the, or even we can take the mind also, never mind. Different interpretations are. The oil is the karma that we have brought. We say, you know, we have come over here for what? We have come here to exhaust our karmas. When the lamp is burning, slowly, slowly the oil exhausts itself. It becomes less and it becomes less and it becomes less. As the oil is becoming less, as the wick is burning, it's giving light to everybody. So similarly, they say the karma is there. So if the mind, again we can take the mind itself. Or the body, like I said, different interpretations are there. So into this vessel, which is filled with karma, over there, we bring in the wick. Two strands. So the body is the lamp. The oil is the karmas that we have brought, which we want to exhaust in our life. How do we exhaust our karmas? Using the mind and the intellect only. They are the actual doers of any activity. The body is not the doer. The mind and the intellect perform or achieve through the body. Two of them, mind and intellect, two wicks. Put together. When we are using two strands over there, what do? We nicely make them one. They shouldn't be two like that. They should be made into one. Mind and the intellect should be well integrated. They should join together over there. Then light of knowledge can. In the light of knowledge, when our mind and intellect is burning, vik is burning, means we are performing our activities slowly through the body, no doubt, all our karmas will get exhausted. That is also one of the interpretations of lamp. So many meanings are there. These are just two or three significances of lighting the lamp. That is why it is so important for all of us. The lamp means something to us. It's not there sitting outside there. I don't have anything to do, therefore I am lighting the lamp. Or I need it, therefore I am lighting it. It means something very, very substantial, very, very significant and important to ourselves. It represents me. It represents each one of us. The outside, external lamp. It represents to us also the internal. Both of them should be all. Actually, they are not two separate. It's just a nice way of saying that's all. Body, mind, intellect, ultimately, all of them have to integrate, get integrated. Only then, everything that comes out of our life in the form of activity, physical, mental or intellectual, will become very, very beautiful. They'll all get very nicely aligned with the divine will, with the universal will. Only then it will all be music and dance of life. There will be no apaswara, no wrong notes in our life. Because the lamp is being used properly. For itself and for everybody else. This is the significance of lighting the lamp. So it is showing goal, it is showing purpose, it is showing everything over there for us. It is showing us the path. This is the significance of lighting the lamp.